Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we want to go through how to schedule a monthly maintenance in my Microsoft Access database. So when you open the database, you have the main menu, and when you want to schedule a preventive maintenance, you go to the preventive maintenance and it shows you a dashboard where you schedule all periods of preventive maintenance, which includes the daily, weekly, fortnightly, monthly, quarterly, yearly, bi-yearly, and yearly. So now today we want to concentrate on the monthly maintenance. So what you have on this fonts that are showing red are maintenance that are due soon. So this maintenance are due within several intervals of this period. So the daily is due, of course, the following day. The weekly is due within 3 days. The reminder shows. And the fortnightly is within 4 days. The monthly is within 5 days. Sorry. The quarterly is due within 2 weeks. And the bi-yearly in 30 days. And the yearly in 45 days. So let's go ahead and schedule a monthly maintenance. Right now we have only 4 monthly PM that is due. So as you can see, today's date is the 3rd of July, and as you can see, we still have 1 day due for this PM that has been complete. So it will remain on the system till the date it has been completed. So we want to schedule a new maintenance. Monthly maintenance. We can go to the this equipment. We'll put in the equipment. And then we'll put in the PM description. So if we want to know how to add equipment to the database, I already showed that on my other videos, but I'll go through it one more time. We can do that by either going on the dashboard or on the main menu screen. We can do that here. And also we could do that here, where you can add equipment and email list. And the fastest way to do it while we are on the dashboard is by going here, and we can add the equipment and the email. We separate the emails by semicolon if we want to add up to 10 email address. So that's in case you have several maintenance employees and you want to add the email. So make sure that you add the email address, because that's how it sends out the notification. It takes the email address and sends the notification through the email address. So if you want to schedule a monthly maintenance, let's go back here and we'll put in the PM description. This description is called the job list. So basically it's the task that will be performed on the PM. We can populate that by going here and adding those information on the job list and linking it to the equipment. So say for instance, if we are performing this task, we put in, right, type in the task, and then we link it, the task, to a specific equipment. So let's get out of here. And let's go back to our monthly maintenance. We put in the name of the maintenance technician, the service company, if we have one. And we can put the notes if we need to put a note here. And we'll put in how to. This is a hyperlink. We can put in attach whatever documents that we want to attach here. And here we add in the parts that are required for the maintenance, and as you can see, it automatically calculates the cost of the part. That way we can get an estimate of how much it will cost you to perform the maintenance. And then you can put in how many hours it takes to perform the maintenance, and it's best to fill out this information once the maintenance has been complete. But this 1, 2, 3, this, the asterisk, the one in asterisk are the ones that you have to do initially for the system to start schedule a PM. If you leave any of these three blank, it wouldn't schedule the PM. So make sure you fill it out. So we are scheduling the monthly. So when we put in schedule a date, it calculates from the current date. So today is the 3rd. If you put in the 3rd of July, it will automatically calculate to the 2nd, which is 30 days, the 2nd of August. So just for tutorial purposes, we want to go back 30 days. And if we go back 30 days, let's go back 28 days. Today is the 3rd. Let's just go back one more day. So tomorrow is when this PM is due. Because we wanted to send out an email. I want to show you how the email looks like for a monthly maintenance. So after we're done, we've completed this. And the database automatically calculates the due date. And things, these two box, they completed and the click to schedule an SPM. This should be done after the PM has been completed. So what this does is it takes it out of the reminder. This, the red font here, it takes it out of that. So once you check this box, it will no longer show you the reminder. And once you are done and you want to schedule another PM, you check this box and it automatically populates all this information down here so you can schedule another preventive maintenance, another monthly preventive maintenance. So once we have done scheduling the preventive maintenance, we close it. Notice that it's 4 monthly PMs. So after we close this form to refresh, it will automatically goes to 5. Let's check it out. So let's close this form. Close this one as well. Close this one as well. We'll go back to our preventive maintenance. As you can see, it's now 5. Right? And also, the timer here is not from vanity. The purpose of this timer is to, for every second, it will send out a reminder to your email address. Mind you, the email is only sent once and it's sent 3 days before the PM is due. So for the monthly, like I said before, on the monthly, it sends out a reminder. It sends out a reminder 5 days before the PM is due. However, the email is sent 3 days before it's due. So the reminder is just this notification on the dashboard. And let's go to our email and let's see your scheduled. So if you can see now, it sends you an email saying that you have a PM that is due. So we have a monthly PM due. It sends us a due date and tells us the task description, which is basically the job list that I have there. Just to wrap it up, we have the purpose of this is just a reminder. It gives you a reminder, sends you a reminder, and also sends you an email as well. And if you want to see the completed and incompleted records, you can go here for the monthly. And then when you check this box, it shows you the completed. When you uncheck it, it shows you the ones that hasn't been completed. And you save and close. If you want to see it in a spreadsheet format, you go in this section here, you click monthly, it gives you everything on records. All right. So that's all for the monthly. If you want to know how to get this database, please go to the link below. If you have any further questions, just email me. All right. Thank you very much for staying to the end of this video. You have a wonderful day.